Hello, welcome to Paul's Take. Today we're installing this differential skid plate cover. It's a cover that goes over your differential in the front, designed to fit all Dana 30 axles, fits over your stock differential cover, constructed of durable 3/16-inch steel, powdered coated. All mounting hardware and instructions are included, 5-year warranty. That's what it looks like from the outside. And here's what it looks like in the flesh. So this thing is definitely made with some thick, solid steel. Yeah, so that's going to make it much more protected. Because from underneath, when I went off-roading, I hit something. But I don't know what I hit. But it seems like the most vulnerable thing is that differential right there. It's hanging down below your vehicle. So I already took off the bolts. They were easy enough. It was a 13-millimeter socket, and let's see how easy it is to put this thing on. It comes with these, right? So hopefully, I heard some reviews that they strip. So I'll put them there nice and easy and safe. So let's try it out. I'll tell you how it goes. Okay, one important thing, this Allen wrench key is not gonna be nearly long enough or strong enough to tighten the little, you know, screws tight enough. You can't do it. Not enough leverage. You're gonna have to have one of these. A socket, I don't know, Allen wrench thing up. Now that will do it. I think it'll do it because I got to work and it was leaking a little bit. So I tightened them down. It should be strong enough now. I'm assuming they tighten enough. So I'll do a little test drive and see if it's still leaking. Let's find out. All right, so we're gonna take it for a little drive, try to build up some pressure in that differential. Figures as it's spinning, it's creating some velocity, pushing the oil outwards towards the seals. So we're gonna see if we can build up a little speed and see if it leaks at all. I think I tightened it enough. I'm not sure. So I'll figure as fast as I can and not crash into a tree. Road closed. I think that should be enough speed. Just washed it, or my wooden chair, but I just washed the car. That's why I'm saying that. All right, I went for a nice vigorous drive, even more so than I showed you. I kept on going and drive fast as I could, hard as I could for the period of time. And I, so far, I don't see any juice. But I got a paper towel right here. I'm gonna go scrape around and see if I can find it. I'm trying to dry as best I could. Yeah, I think I did a pretty good job. So I think it was coming from the side over here. And it looks clean. No juice right there. It might be residual from before. Or not. I'm not really sure. You know, I guess I was hopefully that's residual from before. Try to dry it like I said, best I could. I still see juiciness around it. Not sure if I really try to dry too much on this side. I don't know. I'm a little nervous. I don't think I did too much drying on this side. I didn't think the side was a problem. But maybe it is the problem. Oh yeah, I see juice underneath. That sure might be from before though. This sucks. So anyways, it seems to me your best option is to use actual bolts instead of these little crappy hexes. You can only torque them so much. I think I'm not getting enough torque out of them. So that's not good. I'm gonna drag. I guess I'll see if how much oil is still in there. You use that right there. All right, so far I don't see any more leaking. I think we're good. If we're good, that means there's no more parts of this video. But if there's another part, that means we're not good. And we're still leaky. So there it is, nice and safe. Except for leaking. Probably switch out those bolts as soon as I can. Thanks for watching Paul's Take, and that is the differential armor from, I forgot the name. Thanks for watching Paul's Take. Make sure to like, subscribe for more videos. Wow, kept that with the Porsche a little bit. Can't believe it. Not too shabby for a Jeep.